In quantum physics, the Schrödinger equation is used for such potential systems or particles that gives an exact solution, such as particle in 1D box, simple harmonic oscillator, hydrogen atom, or tunneling through a rectangular barrier. These are idealized systems that give exact solutions. But there are many such systems in the quantum physics in which we do not get exact solution. For such a system, approximation method is used. Several approximation methods have been developed, such as perturbation theory, variational method, and WKB method. Perturbation theory is based on the fact that if we know the exact solution of a system, then due to some slight change in that system, what will be the new solution? Like we know the solution of a particle in 1D box system, wave function and eigenvalue exactly. If the potential of this 1D box is modified slightly, some additional terms are added to the wave function and eigenvalue, which is the solution for the new system. In this way, adding correction to previously known wave function and eigenvalue is called perturbation theory. The perturbation theory requires that the exact solution of the unperturbed system to be known. If we do not know any wave function or eigenvalue of a system, then in that case, variational or WKB approximation method is used. The variational method can be used if we have a qualitative idea of the wave function for a given system. Like we want to know the ground state solution of the particle in 1D harmonic oscillator by variational method. So since the potential well of a 1D harmonic oscillator is symmetric, so its corresponding wave function must be symmetric, means term of even power of x or x square. On plus minus infinity, the wave function should be vanished, means power of exponential has to be negative term. No node point is created, means there is no individual polynomial term of odd power of x. Therefore, the wave function will be similar to e to the power minus ax square. The variational method is normally used to calculate the ground state or some excited states. The WKB method is used to find the energy eigenvalue and wave function of those systems for which the classical limit is valid. Let us assume there is a potential system in which the potential is slowly varying. WKB approximation requires that the variation in potential to be short compared to the de Broglie wavelength lambda of the particle. That is to say, even though the potential is varying, the variation should be so low and slow that it remains constant for the particle's 1 de Broglie wavelength region. Only then WKB approximation can be applied. The WKB method was independently discovered in 1926 by Wenzel, Kramers and Brulin. In their names, this method is called the WKB method. In fact, mathematician Jeffrey also discovered it in 1923. Therefore, this method is also sometimes called JWKB approximation. The WKB method has its particularly two applications. First, in calculating the energy of a bound state, and second, to calculating the tunneling rate from a potential barrier. To understand the essential idea behind the WKB method, let's assume an E-energy particle moving in the V-potential region. The Schrödinger equation of this particle will be minus h cross square upon 2m d2 psi over dx square plus V psi equals to E psi. If we rearrange it, we get d2 psi over dx square plus 2m upon h cross square E minus V psi equals to 0. Where 2m upon h cross square E minus V represents with k square. If the energy of the particle is greater than potential, the solution of the equation is A e to the power plus minus iota kx, where k is the momentum of the particle. In the wave function, the plus sign indicates wave traveling towards the right side and minus sign indicates left side traveling wave. It is an oscillatory sinusoidal wave function, which wavelength is 2 pi by k. From the de Broglie equation, and amplitude is A. If the energy of the particle is less than the potential, by rearranging of the Schrödinger equation, the solution of the equation will be A e to the power plus minus kx. Now suppose potential is not constant, but is varying with position. But this variation is much less than the particle's de Broglie wavelength. This variation is so low that the potential remains constant for many wavelength reasons. Since the variation in potential is very low, it can be assumed that the nature of the wave function will not change. Means, if the wave function is sinusoidal, then it will remain the same. Due to such slowing varying potential, the nature of the wave function will not change, but the wavelength and amplitude varying slowly. This is the idea behind WKB approximation. But there is a point in this potential region where this whole approximation fails. The point at which the energy of the particle is equal to the potential. At this point, the wavelength becomes infinite, and in this situation we cannot say that the potential is varying slowly. Rather, a single wavelength becomes infinite length at this point, and the potential is varying in this region. This point is called classical turning point. The classical turning point is the point where the classically particle reverses the direction of its motion. This region is called classical region. To understand the behavior of the particle in the classical region, let's solve the Schrodinger equation. If the particle's energy is E and it is moving in V potential region, then rearranging the Schrodinger equation d2 psi over dx square equals to minus 2m upon h cross square E minus V psi. When 2m E minus V is equalized to p square, d2 psi over dx square equals to minus p square upon h cross square psi, where p is the classical momentum of the particle. This is the classical formula for particle momentum. Keep in mind that the classical momentum of the particle is h cross time of quantum momentum. If the energy of the particle is more than the potential barrier, then the momentum will be positive. This region is called classical region because the particle will remain confined in this region. The oscillatory solution of the equation is A e to the power plus minus iota phi x, where A is the amplitude and phi is the phase. If rewriting the solution for one direction only, then psi equals to A e to the power iota phi x. Taking the derivative of this solution and putting it back into the equation 1, we get this equation. This equation has two parts, one real and the other imaginary. On separating them, the real part A double dash equals to A phi dash square minus p square upon h cross square and imaginary part equals to 0. By further solving this equation, we get the value b upon under root phi dash of amplitude A. But equation 3 real part cannot be solved so easily. For this, we have to use approximate method. Assuming that due to variation in potential, amplitude A is varying very slowly, then the variation in A double dash will be also very low. Or to say precisely, the ratio of A double dash and A will be very low compared to phi dash square or p square upon h cross square. So we equate A double dash to negligible 0. In this case, solving this equation gives phi equals to plus minus 1 upon h cross integration p dx. When phi put back in equation 4, the value of amplitude A is found in term of the momentum. Putting both solution back into equation 2, we get the general approximate solution. This solution is only for traveling wave in one direction. Similar, a general solution of traveling wave in other direction can be found. As we know that psi has no physical meaning, but its mod square tells the probability. Upon mod square of this function, mod of psi square equals to c square upon p. According to this, the probability of the particle being at some point is inversely proportional to its classical momentum. This is the result we are expecting. The particle will spend the least time at the position where its velocity is maximum. Because of the high momentum, the particle will move away from that position very fast and it will reduce the probability of its occurrence. Conversely, at the point momentum will low, the particle will spend a lot of time, due to which the probability of particle being at that point will be more. In this way, in this video, we learned the essential idea behind the WKB approximation method. If you want to know about the application of the WKB method and want a video, then comment us.